Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
The Scottish Terrier is a big dog in a small package. They're nicknamed the die-hard breed. They'll die trying, and they will stand up to any size dog, and they won't quit. My name is Rod Ott. I have owned Scottish Terriers since 1995, and I raise and breed Scottish Terriers and exhibit them under the Bravo Scottish Terrier kennel prefix, along with my wife, Pilar Kuhn. I first discovered the breed back in the mid-90s. I was actually married to my first wife for about a year, and my ex-in-laws had a Scottish Terrier boy named Gus. There's just certain qualities about a Scottie that are unique in that people that are around them that own them fall in love with. So after being married about a year, their daughter ran off with another guy, left me alone, and they showed up on, her parents and her brother showed up on my doorstep one night with a four-month-old Scottish Terrier puppy named Molly. And so I tell everybody I got the better bitch out of the deal. That was my first exposure as being a Scottie owner, and I've been breeding and showing and exhibiting now for over 20 years. The breed originated in Scotland. It was a mixture of several different terrier breeds that developed into the Scottie. Late 1800s, around past 1880, the first Scottie was brought to England, and the breed developed there and started showing and being registered with the kennel club in England. It wasn't until the late 1880s that the first Scotties were brought to the United States and started being bred and shown and exhibited and registered with the American Kennel Club. And the Scottish Terrier Club of America, which is our parent club, was first recognized in 1900. The Scottish Terrier was bred to hunt vermin. They went bred to go to ground for badgers and to go after foxes and other vermin that are earth dwellers. Scotties are not afraid. They will stand up to a badger and go in a hole and take it out. They will die trying if that's what it comes to. They're not afraid of any other animal like that. And that's also why a Scottie has a short, fat tail like a upside down carrot. That was developed so the owner could reach in the hole and pull their dog out with the badger still in the dog's strong, powerful jaws. Well, as far as phenotype for the Scottish Terrier that makes them unique for going to ground after vermin, they have short legs, a deep chest, and that's so that dog can rest on that keel and dig with those short legs, and a Scottie will push the dirt out to the side rather than behind between their legs. The dirt goes out to the side, and they have a nice long head, powerful jaws, and big teeth, and that helps them hold on to the vermin as they try to dispatch it and pull it out. Other modern breeds connected to the Scottie, the Skye Terrier has some connection back in the 1800s. One of the modern breeds that has a connection would be the Cheeck Terrier, which is a cross between a Scottish Terrier and a Sealyham Terrier. Variations on the breed, there's not a lot of variations other than coat color. As far as the American Kennel Club, they recognize six colors. You have black, brindle, and wheaten. Wheaten color can range from a light cream to a dark cinnamon color. And for brindle, you can have black brindle, silver brindle, or red brindle with different shades of those. As far as size, our standard in the U.S., the females range from 18 to 20 pounds, and males are 20 to 22 pounds. Our standard calls for a height of 10 inches at the shoulder. But back length and head length and height, you know, those are desired measurements that are in our standard. They're going to vary a little bit with between each dog, and you still want a dog that's properly balanced. The Scottish Terrier breed became popular early in the 20th century. I think a lot of that was due to marketing and advertising. The profile of the Black Scottish Terrier is very popular on clothing items, and that increased the popularity. As far as the temperament is of a Scotty, they are a somewhat aloof breed. They can be, especially to strangers. But as far as their family members, they're very loyal for their entire life to that family. And they do take some time to get to know strangers, but once they do, they love them just as well. Health issues in the Scottish Terrier, some of the bigger ones are Cushing's disease, bladder cancer, Scotty cramp, not so much anymore. I think the breeders have done a good job weeding out Scotty cramp. Von Willebrand's disease, which is a bleeding disorder, is another thing we test for, which we don't see that very much anymore in the U.S. That it's still something we routinely test for with the DNA test. CMO is another one. Liver shunt is a new one that's started to pop up recently. I think most reputable breeders try to do the health testing that's recommended by the parent club. There's some that are required, some that are optional in order to get your chick number. But every breed has different health tests required by their parent club. Scottish Terriers, I think, are a good fit for a lot of people. As far as little kids, is I think as long as they're raised with the kids, and as a parent, you teach your kids that, hey, don't pull on a Scottie's beard, you know, don't startle them. They get along fine. We know a lot of breeders with children that the kids are involved along with the parents, showing and raising puppies. Activity level, Scotties, they like to be active. It's a breed that you want to have a fenced yard if they're off leash. It's not a breed that you want to let off leash, because Scotties have such a strong prey drive that they will take off on you. So if you go for long walks with them, which they do enjoy, make sure you do it on leash. It's not a breed that they're not good swimmers. They cannot swim because of their short little legs and heavy torso. They sink really well. So if a family, what's one of the questions we ask when we're screening puppy buyers, if they have a pool and if that pool is fenced in and secure, because we don't want to sell our puppy somewhere and have it drown. Socialization with this breed is very important. And I think just like with any breed, it's good to expose them to a lot of different activities and environments so they're not intimidated when they face them for the first time. It's good to socialize them among other dogs. So, you know, because a Scotty will not stand down to another dog if it's aggressive toward it. You know, a Scotty will die trying if it has to. They will not give up to another breed. So, like, if you go to a dog park and a Scotty will faces an aggressive dog loose in a dog park, it will challenge it. So we don't recommend going to dog parks, you know, for that reason. And it's a good place to pick up, you know, whatever flu bug or thing, kennel cough that's going around. So we avoid those. Today we saw the first dog, Mona Lisa. She's a red brindle female, 15 months old. She's an ornery little cuss in our household. She's had a very successful past weekend at the dog shows at Great Western Terrier. The first day she was best of opposite in sweepstakes. The next day she was winner's bitch and best of winners for a 5-point major and best bred by exhibitor Scotty, and went on to win best bred by in show at the Great Western Terrier show. And then the following day, she finished up with another winner's bitch best of winners for another 5-point major. So we're real excited about her future, in the show ring. The next dog was a black male named Noble. He's 2 years old, and he is already a champion in the American Kennel Club, with finishing with several majors. Last year, he was winner's dog with a supported entry at the Great Western Terrier Show. The third dog we saw was a black female named Gabby. She's about 2.5 years old. She's already a champion. She also finished her championship winning the Terrier Group, placing Group 1. The last dog we saw was Asami. She was the one that was clippered down with her litter of puppies that are 6 weeks old. And today was their first venture out into the outdoors on grass for the first time. Today we met the Scottish Terrier, a breed that has a lot of unique personality and characteristics. I think there's a lot of people that have Scotties, they have them for the rest of their life just because of the unique qualities about the breed. They're not a breed for everyone. You know, they are a very independent natured dog, and they like to do things their own way, and they are trainable. You need to start training them from an early age, from puppyhood, you know, and be firm and be committed and don't change the rules. They need to know what the rules are. They also excel at things like rally and agility and earth dog, because that's one thing they were bred for. So they're earth dog competitions where they go to ground after a caged rat, which is humanely taken care of. The rat is not hurt, but they learn to go through tunnels and find the vermin. They're a good, loyal companion. Most of the time they're your buddies on the couch, and they follow you everywhere. And if you're looking to get a Scottish Terrier, be prepared to do your work and look for good, reputable breeders. And there are good resources out there, like our parent club. Scottish Terrier Club of America has, for example, a breeder referral list. Also, as a puppy buyer, you want to inquire with that breeder as to the health status of their dogs, what's the history in their genetic line of cancer or Scotty cramp, or, you know, ask for evidence of their health test results. You know, and the best thing to do is actually and what we prefer as breeders, that you come to our house, you meet us, you meet the mother of the puppies, you see how they were raised. And, you know, when you buy a puppy, you're getting us for the life of that puppy. And we are always willing to take that dog back if anything should happen to you as a puppy buyer. So, you know, we love this breed, and we're trying to preserve it and carry it on into the future. So it's here forever.